This year, the Universal Church is marking a special year for priests. Our Holy Father proclaimed June 19, 2009 through June 19, 2010 as a time for celebration, which had helped priests rediscover the grace and the goal of their priestly ministry. This year, coincidentally, marks the 25th anniversary of priesthood of our bishop, Bishop Michael Burbidge, who is with us today to talk about his vocation. Congratulations on the milestone anniversary.
Thank you very much, Frank.
And this being the year for priests and your anniversary is occurring, this should make it a little bit special.
Well, it does. What a great year to celebrate the 25th anniversary. The church provides wonderful opportunities to lift up particular vocations. Our Holy Father, in a special way, has lifted up the priesthood for all of us. And it's the 25th anniversary of me celebrating the wonderful gift of priesthood. And surely that's what it is. It's a gift from the Lord Himself.
25 years. Was it a fast 25 or a slow 25?
Very, very fast. I always remember sitting in the seminary chapel, and we would have a mass each year for those celebrating 25 years of priesthood. And I would look at them and say, they looked pretty old. How do you do this for such a long time? And So I guess seminarians may be saying that about me now.
Incredible. Some priests and religious know from a very early age that that is what they want to be. Others could take decades before they come to that realization that God is calling them. How did it happen for you?
It happened at an early age, I mean, that I would first feel that the Lord may be asking me to be a priest. I would look at priests in awe. I was in such respect of them, held them in high esteem. I was blessed in my life going to Catholic school and growing up in a Catholic neighborhood of just wonderful priests always around us. When I went to high school, amazingly, think about this, but I had 20-some priests on my diocesan high school faculty, young priests that I would see every day that the students loved. They were holy, they were joyful, they did so much to help the students. And then I began to think about the priesthood, especially when one of the priests asked me if I would ever consider that and told me he thought I would be a good priest. And that's when I began to think, well, maybe this is a possibility. But in all honesty, when I went into seminary, I just reached a point where I knew I had to try this. I knew it. It was just, I knew I was not going to be happy doing anything else unless I try this. But there was also in the back of my mind that I would go in there and find out it probably wasn't for me. Now I could get on with the rest of my life. But the opposite happened. I was in the seminary for about 6 months, and I knew I was going to be a priest. Sometimes people say that when they fall in love. They see the person, and they said, that's the one for me. And I knew it. And that's not the experience of every seminarian. Some people go into seminary, and they learn that God's calling them to something else. I knew I was going to be a priest, and I never have looked back on it. And the priest who mentioned that to me was at my installation. I became Bishop of Raleigh, so that was special to me.
Tremendous. Yeah. Your family, your parents, were they supportive of your decision to enter seminary?
They were. They were surprised, though. I had a very close relationship with my parents and my family. But for some reason, and I still don't understand why, when I was thinking seriously about being a priest, and I was usually very open with everything, I just didn't share that discernment piece with them. And to this day, I'm not sure why I did that. And when I told them then, I had been thinking about it for a while, but that was the first time they were hearing it. So my parents, my brother, they were very surprised. And yet, in my parents' typical fashion, reaffirmed what they would often say to my brother and me, well, whatever you're going to do, you make sure you do it to the best of your ability and be the best you can be, and you have our support. But once they came into the seminary community with the other parents and family members, it became a very special part of their lives too.
What was the most challenging part of seminary life for you?
The idea of you knew you were being called to such a beautiful life and the responsibility that the Lord entrusts to his priests. And in the midst of that, being aware of your own limitations and weaknesses and dealing with that call of feeling unworthy. And yet through the great spiritual directors we had and formators, explaining that really none of us are worthy. It's a gift. It's God's call, and God will ask us to do our best. And if we cooperate with His grace, would use us even in our weaknesses as His instruments.
I want to jump ahead a little bit, because you mentioned rectoring. And you were a rector.
Yes.
Once you became ordained a priest, you had a couple of pastoral assignments, but then you were a rector. Being a rector, having been a seminarian, etc., you have a feel for what these young men now are going through, correct?
I do, yes.
And how does that help you understand the seminarians?
It helps a great deal. I was very blessed because prior to being rector, I was working in the Archdiocesan Office Center closely with the Cardinal and with the Vicar for Clergy's office. And so you would see the many blessings that priests were experiencing in their lives, but also some of their struggles. And so you saw that these are some of the issues that probably more and more could be addressed effectively at a younger age in the formation process. So I felt when I went to the seminary as rector, I understood the issues clearly. And then as was able to get to know the young men. And the one thing that I had to be careful of, they were different than I was and my peers were when we were in the seminary. It's a different culture. It's a different age. It's a different generation. So I had to spend a little bit of time learning what they were bringing to the seminary, what gifts they were, and what their challenges would be. But I thought that was one of the best assignments I had being rector, of waking up on a campus every morning with 170 men giving their lives to the Lord.
Before a rector, and again, I jumped ahead, but after ordination, you were assigned to a parish. How
yes.
was parish life?
I loved parish life. I had hoped that I would be assigned to a parish that would be in a sort of like a neighborhood I grew up in. And sure enough, I was. There were 3,300 families in the parish and 1,200 kids in the school, and no one drove to church. Everyone walked to church. It was that type of neighborhood. No buses to school. The kids all walked to school. So it was a very close-knit, large, but very close parish community and neighborhood. I lived with five priests at the time. And I was blessed as a newly ordained priest with one of the finest pastors a new priest could have. Someone I held with the greatest respect and admiration. I loved dearly. And it became a very special part of my life. Sadly, he died at a very young age, but I will never forget his example and constantly turn to him for his intercession.